All right, well, I got a bunch of little cedars to repot here. Next in the series of max trees. By my count, there's, I think, 17 little trees in here. A couple of them might be dead, but I've got 17 individual containers here. I might not need all of them, but figured I'd have them all on standby anyways. Get a drainage layer in them. It's just the larger bits of perlite that I sift out of my soil. Probably need some of those black ones, but I'll just fill these ones up for now. Rather, I'll just put the bottom drainage layer in them for now. So again, these are just in the sand that I collected from where they were growing. Goes bottom. There were no living roots down there, that just popped off like that. Got some roots growing along the side. There's some fresh white growing tips there. Not too many. Not as much as was on the two cedars from yesterday. Not a lot of roots in here. Okay, one just fell out there. Not a bad little root system on that. Looks alive. There's a little growing tip. Little growing tip in there. Everything looks green. Put this in one of these pots. Somewhere there. I didn't quite get that deep enough. and just put a little stone on there, a little bit more soil. Grow up fairly straight from there. Nice little starter bonsai. Okay, what else we got in here? I don't know if that one's alive. Looks pretty dead. Not worth even trying. I've got so many of these. It's a tiny one, it can go in the smallest pot. These are all the smallest ones. I clumped them together when I first potted them. All the really small ones together and then the slightly larger ones together. Okay. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Already did 2. So that'll be 12 already. And some of them I'll plant 2 to a pot. Especially these black ones. Okay. Smallest one can go in here. Try and do this a little better this time. Let's put 2 really small ones in here. These 2, probably the least developed. I need to try and get those a little deeper in the soil. Okay, let's do closer, these two. I'm not gonna cut the roots on any of these. They're too small already. Six and seven. Okay, I'm gonna put three in here actually. Those two together. And they're a little close together, but that's fine. They're still farther apart than they were originally. Eight, nine, and ten. And 12. That's all of the really small ones, I think. These ones are slightly larger. I think that's dead at the end. I'll just do that for now. Try it. I'll put it in this almost broken pot here. That'll be fine for now. Lucky number 13. Plant most of these two to a pot, I think. I don't think that one made it. I think this one's alive. Yeah, this one looks better than this one does. So we've got 2, 4, 6, and then we can put the 2 sickly looking ones together. And 15 might not make it, but that's okay. There's a few more trees in here than I thought there were. 4 more, actually. Maybe 21. Only 19 of them might be alive. And I already threw out a couple. They were pretty tightly packed in there. It was hard to tell how many there were. So as I was saying earlier, I don't think it's worth even touching the roots at this stage. I just want them to survive and grow on a little bit, and I can worry about roots next year. Pruning them anyways. And the last 2. This one's pretty tiny, actually. It's pretty good. I'll label the pots so we can all keep track together and see which ones survive, which ones grow better, any differences between them. Here they all are together. We'll give them a real thorough soaking to get rid of any dust and small particulate matter in there. Pretty much grain size of my soil is pretty much 1 to 6 millimeters. I sift out everything larger than that and smaller than that, so here we are.